In this video, we're going to talk about Simpson's paradox, which is just something odd that can happen when you look at data. So in general, a paradox is something that happens that doesn't make sense logically. And in math, when we're talking about Simpson's paradox, what we mean by this is it's possible for a set of data to give different results in each of several groups compared to what happens when the groups are taken together. So when you look at data in some ways, you get one result. But when you look at it like all together and combined, you get a different result that doesn't quite make sense. So let's look at an example. Suppose a pharmaceutical company creates a new treatment for acne. To decide whether the new treatment is better than an older treatment, the company conducts a test. So the old treatment is given to 90 patients and the new treatment is given to 110 patients. And so we see our chart here showing people with mild acne. 2 were cured with the old treatment and 30 were cured with the new treatment. And then there were 8 of them that were not cured with the old and 60 that were cured with the new. And same thing with severe acne. There were 40 that were cured from the old treatment and 12 that were cured from the new treatment. And then there were 40 that were not cured from the old and 8 that were not cured with the new. So we have all of our data down there. So let's just look at the people with mild acne. We had 10 that received the old treatment and 90 that received the new treatment. So we want to know, what are the cure rates? Well, for the old treatment, we had 2 that got cured out of the 10 that got it. So that was a cure rate of 20%. And then with the new treatment, 30 got it out of the 90, or 30 were cured out of the 90 total that got it for a cure rate of 33.33%. So the new worked better for mild acne, since with the new treatment, 33% were cured, and with the old treatment, only 20% were cured. Looking with the severe acne, we had 80 people that got the old treatment and we had 20 people that got the new treatment. So with the old treatment, 40 out of the 80 were cured, so 50%. And then with the new treatment, only 12 out of 20 were cured, so 60%. So again, the new treatment works better with severe acne. So right here, the company could take the data and say, on mild acne and severe acne, our new treatment performs better than the old treatment because in both cases, the new did have a higher cure rate. But maybe the FDA or somebody comes along and they look at the total cure rates and they say, well, there were 90 people total that received the old treatment. Of those, 42 were cured. And there were 110 people total that received the new treatment, and of those, 42 were cured. So the old treatment cured about 47%, and the new treatment cured about 38%. Therefore, the old treatment worked better. Therefore, the company's lying in their advertising, and they could stick them with a lawsuit. So who's telling the truth here? Is it the company saying that looking at the mild versus severe separately, the new did perform better in both cases? Or is it the FDA looking at everyone all together saying that, well, now the old works better than the new? And there's not really a right answer. You know, yes, the old treatment had a higher cure rate overall than the new one, but the new one seemed to work better for both mild and severe. So both sides are telling the truth from their point of view. Neither side is lying. And so that's why it's helpful to really define what it is you're looking at and, get a feel for, if you're arguing over data, how are they compiling the data? Because data can sometimes give different results depending on how you look at it. And this is Simpson's paradox because it doesn't quite make sense. And Simpson's paradox arises most frequently when you're taking your overall population into different sized groups. Our groups were not equal in the number of people that had mild and severe and the number of people that got the treatment versus didn't get the treatment. You got the old versus the new. So be very careful when you're looking at data if things are not done very equally, because it can throw off the numbers, just like in this example.